Hey guys, welcome back to Indian Regional Recipes. I hope you all are doing great. In today's video, we are going to prepare chicken biryani. All the ingredients to prepare this recipe has been already listed on the screen. For your reference, you can check that out. Here we are preparing the biryani masala. Let's see the ingredients that we require to prepare the biryani masala. I'm taking here 10 to 15 peppercorns, some cumins, a small piece of mace, a small piece of cinnamon stick, one cardamom, three cloves, a small piece of dagad phool, that is called stone flower in English if I'm not mistaken, a small piece of star anise. We need to make a fine powder out of it and keep it handy. If you don't want to get into all this headache, then you can just bring a small packet of biryani masala ready made from the market. Here I'm making a fresh ginger garlic paste. If you have it ready-made or maybe ready-made paste in the fridge, you can use that instead. Here I'm taking around 1 kilo of chicken which I have soaked in the salt water for about 1 to 2 hours. I'm taking that chicken into a bowl, adding the masala, biryani masala powder that we just prepared, ginger garlic paste along with some chopped coriander and mint leaves, some fried onions, some curd, 2 to 3 green chili, some turmeric and red chili powder and coriander powder, and some salt according to your taste. Mix all of them together. You need to ensure that each and every piece of the chicken has been coated nicely, and keep it aside. Let it marinate for about an hour or two. Here I'm taking some water in a big size utensil to prepare rice. I'm adding some oil and salt and some green chilies. I've soaked some spices in the water for about an hour. We need to add that as well to the water. Here I've soaked around 2 to 3 cardamoms, one star anise, some shahjeera, one dagad phool, a small piece of cinnamon stick and one marathi muggu. When the water starts boiling, when it's on its peak, that time you need to remove all the spices with the help of a sieve. If you don't want to remove them, it's completely optional. I don't want to come into my bite. I don't like it, so I'm just removing. If you don't want, you can just leave them as it is. Now I'm adding the rice. I've soaked the rice about an hour's time. I just added the soaked rice. Let it cook about 40 to 50%. And then heat the rice again, remove all the excess water, keep it aside. Do not overcook it, otherwise you will end up making chicken khichdi instead of chicken biryani. If you think because of the heat the cooking process is still on, then you can remove the rice when it was cooked about 30% only. Alright, before cooking the biryani, we need to add some chicken masala and some oil to the marinated chicken. Mix it well. Here I'm taking the same utensil in which I cooked the rice. I just added some clarified butter, ghee. In that I just fried some cashews and keeping them handy. After that I added some bay leaf. In that now I just placed evenly all the marinated chicken. On top of it I place some rice, and on top of it again some fried onions, some cashews and chopped mint and coriander leaves, and some clarified butter again. We need to continue this process one more time if you have more rice, otherwise you can just end it up over here. On top of it just add some color if you want, or else you can also add some queso mixed with the milk. That will also bring some color to the biryani, which I don't have it available at my home, so I'm just using the color. I just repeated the same procedure once again because I have so much rice, so I just had to repeat it once again. On the top of the rice and everything, I just added some color along with some a few drops of rose water and some kevda water. Now these two things will bring nice aroma to the biryani. This color thing is completely optional. If you don't want, you can just skip it. Alright, we need to just put the lid on it. You have to ensure that the air or the moisture will not pass through the lid. You need to cover completely the utensil, and on top of it just place some heavy weight, and then you need to cook about 8 to 10 minutes on the medium flame direct on the stove, and then 5 minutes on the low flame again direct on the stove, and then just remove it. And then now place one chapati tawa or something, iron pan or something, on the gas, and then on top of it on the tawa you need to place this utensil and cook it about half an hour on the low flame. Here I'm making very simple raita. I'm adding some chopped onions, green chilies, coriander, some tomatoes and some roasted cumin powder along with some salt and curd. Just mix it well, that's all. A very simple raita, yummy raita. It's ready within 5 minutes. After placing the biryani pot on the tawa, just cook it about 30 to 35 minutes on the low flame. After that, just leave it about an hour's time, let it settle, then you can open and check. And if you are cooking the way I am teaching you here, then you can just remove the lid and just check at the bottom. If there is some liquid still remains, then you can cook it for five more minutes maybe. That's all guys, you can see the biryani, the chicken pieces also very soft and juicy and tender it looks, you can see in the video. Well guys, thank you so much for watching my video. I hope you all like this. Then please subscribe to my channel, share it with your friends and family, and do let me know if you want me to make a video on any particular recipe. I'm glad to make that. Thank you so much.